gunfu here. This is going to be a little bit different because I'm going to show you how to build an arrow redstone detection device. So enjoy, you beautiful weirdos. Thought I'd show you how to do how to build a redstone device that will detect arrow fire in succession. This is just going to be a simple design. There's a lot more you could add to it, but as an overview, I think this is pretty cool. I built this on another server. This is a more concise version of what I built. I just put those blocks there because you need a small hole to fire the arrow through. This is a detector, obviously. The observer will detect the arrow coming through. It's important that the hole is as close to the observer as possible. If it's at the top side, the spider web won't be triggered, or the string. I build two initially, just to show you guys how they interlock. However, I did always intend to have three, so I built the third one afterwards. I was going to build it initially, so one reset went down that one line there, but it wasn't quite enough room. Plus, I wanted to show you how to make it so that this bit of voice can go in succession. You can do what I originally was going to show you there, but you have to do layers, and I wanted this to be a simple design, not as complicated as it can get. But the whole idea of this is, as soon as it gets an impulse coming from the observer, this here stays on. Now, because the way the comparators work, as long as the signal coming in from the side is stronger than the signal coming in from behind, it will turn off, which then allows you to have a open line, powered line, that can be toggled off. I forgot at the stage that I was going to make three of them, so this is a little bit of an error. Right about here, I was like, what an idiot. So in order to prevent the second target getting activated early, first, you have to put in this system. What this does is, until this piston here gets activated, no matter how many times that observer detects an arrow strike, it will not advance the game until the first one has been triggered. Yeah, so the first target is hit, then the observer sends out a signal, and the system stays on, which sends a signal to the piston beneath the second target, activating it. So as soon as the second target's observer detects an arrow, it will now begin the succession. I use the sea lantern to make sure that you can easily see the targets. Now I'm starting to make the third detector. Once again, this is so the second, the first target is hit, the second target will be detected, and now the second target's targeted will now activate the third target. So yeah, the first target allows the second target to be powered, the second one when hit will power the third one so it can be hit. If you leave it on one tick, sometimes you won't get a power and out of it at all. An output, sorry. Two ticks works. Three ticks works. This line I'm making here is the reset line. It's so you can manually reset it. This is the detector, so at the end of this of the game, when you've successfully hit every target in the right order, this one here will put an output so you can then fire fireworks into the air, you know. And if you want, you can run a line underneath everything so they can gonna win a present, win some kind of trophy underneath their feet, comes through the ground. Also, you can connect up to the same output from this observer there and connect it to that line that I just pushed, and that will put an automatic reset. I didn't build it because this is just showing you very simply how to do it. Simple design. It's solely so you can advance it as you like. Thanks for watching. That's it. You can go now.
English, motherfucker! Do you speak it?
That's all, folks.